On every month or one day, our happiness increases to the peak of mountains and gradually decreases to the sea level. The happiest day is called salary day, and the person who does this magic is called bank. Bank story can be very boring as it is involved only in taking deposits, giving loans at higher interest. But this bank story is different. So we are going to talk about successful journey of HDFC Bank and the person behind it. At the end of this video, I have a bonus tip for you. Let's start. HDFC Bank is a subsidiary company of HDFC Limited, a housing loan lending company. Deepak Parekh took over as managing director of HDFC in 1994. HDFC received its banking license from the RBI in 1994. It was Deepak Parekh who zeroed in on Aditya Puri to run this newly formed bank. Parekh, the then MD of HDFC, was not comfortable with lending HDFC's brand name to the bank. He was worried that if the bank didn't do well in the future, the HDFC brand would get damaged. However, Puri wanted the bank to be named HDFC Bank. Puri said that he would not support this name. In the end, Puri won. In the story of HDFC Bank, hiring Puri was no easy task. Puri was heading Citibank's Malaysia operations when he received an offer from Parekh to join the bank. He was a rising star in the Citibank and was among the 50 executives worldwide identified by Citibank's chairman and CEO as being crucial for the bank's future. Hence, he was well paid and had sizable stock options incentivizing him to remain with the bank. It took a lot of persuasion from Parekh to convince Puri to accept the offer. Sizable stock options and the opportunity to be with his father finally convinced Puri to accept it. Puri built most of his team by hiring young bankers from Citibank, Bank of America and HSBC. It was the reputation and pedigree of Puri and Parekh along with an opportunity to build a bank from scratch that would eventually convince people to quit their comfortable and glamorous job at reputed foreign banks and join a startup bank. With neither a balance sheet size nor a branching network, HDFC Bank made inroads into the corporate banking by offering innovative solutions to corporates and customers. An early example, HDFC Bank offered a simple solution to cooperative bank. It issued checks at par to cooperative banks customers through which they could pay their suppliers anywhere in India. The supplier's bank used to settle the money with local branch of HDFC Bank. However, cooperative banks had to keep interest-free deposits with HDFC Bank to get this service. This enabled HDFC Bank to get free money. HDFC Bank did not have the balance sheet size to lend to the corporate. The initial focus was on capturing transactional and cash management business from these corporates rather than lending money to them. Current account and savings account, called as CASA, is the biggest and cheapest source of funds for the bank. Banks do not pay interest on current accounts and pay very low interest on savings account. In comparison, banks pay a higher rate of interest on other source of funds such as fixed deposits, wholesale deposits, etc. HDFC Bank re-engineered the payment process using IT for stock exchanges and their members. In 1997, Puri successfully pitched to the exchanges and their members the idea of converting the manual payment process into a real-time electronic processing system. Dematerialized shares were transferred electronically after trade, but the movement of fund transfers was still slow and in the physical form. This did not match the speed of movement in the stocks as different exchanges used different banks. For example, if a broker in Delhi sold some stocks for a customer, the customer would transfer the sold stock from her or his retail depository participant account to the broker immediately and the broker would electronically transfer the shares to the buyer. However, the fund inflow from the seller was manual and it would take 2 to 3 days for the money to reach the broker and another 2 to 3 days to reach the customer as the clearing bank for the both the exchanges were different. Stockbrokers had to keep liquid money for their payouts despite having equal payments from the other exchanges. This increased the working capital requirements of brokers. For exchanges, the risk was that they were not sure whether stockbrokers had enough money in their accounts to honor payouts. To mitigate this risk, The exchanges had to send data on dues from various brokers to its bank at the end of the day to check whether brokers had enough money to honor their dues. HDFC Bank pulled in all the players in the supply chain, buyers, sellers, brokers, and exchanges, and got them into an automated settlement system. It offered a simple solution to both brokers and exchanges. If brokers had an account with HDFC Bank, exchanges could see in real time whether the broker had money to settle the payouts, and if there was a shortfall, there was enough time before the actual settlement to ask the brokers to meet this shortfall. This reduced settlement risk for exchanges drove all major exchanges to sign with HDFC Bank. The incentive for brokers to sign up with HDFC Bank was that pay-in money was credited immediately to the broker's account, reducing its working capital requirement. This led all the brokers to open their accounts with HDFC Bank for settlement. Since brokers needed bank guarantees for exchanges, the bank also provided credit lines to these brokers. So the bank not only earned a free float on the money kept by the brokers for their settlement, it also earned fees by providing credit lines to the brokers. Starting with the NSE in 1998, the bank became the clearing member of all major exchanges by financial year 2000. 800 brokers and a majority of custodians were using HDFC Bank services by financial year 2000. The bank had captured 80% of the market share in the settlement business by the mid-90s. Leveraging its capital market expertise and depository participant business, the bank also started Loan Against Shares as its first retail product in 1998. And its retail broking business in 2001. A lower lending yield also implied that HDFC Bank was taking less risk than its peers. When an economy suffers a downturn, low credit borrowers find it difficult to pay back a loan, especially those made at high interest rates. HDFC Bank figured out how to take less risk for higher returns. Its focus on blue chip corporate also meant that when issue of asset quality in the corporate lending arose in the banking system in 1998, HDFC Bank was relatively unscathed. With its gross NPA, means non-performing assets, at just 2.54% versus 4.5% for Axis Bank. In January 2000, HDFC Bank became the first bank in India to launch mobile banking. Over financial year 2000 to financial year 2008, the bank expanded its branch network at a CAGR of 27% and its ATM network at a CAGR of 43%. By the end of financial year 2008, HDFC Bank had 761 branches compared to 37 a decade ago, that is 1998. HDFC Bank continued to focus on two key principles in its businesses: building a stable and low-cost liability base and winning client by offering unique solutions. The innovative solutions, low risk management, low cost deposits, good forward goals took HDFC Bank to number one position. HDFC Bank's share price outperformance. A rupee invested in HDFC Bank at its IPO in March 1995 is worth rupees 134 in April 2016, implying a CAGR of 26%. That same would be worth rupees 8 if invested in the Sensex, implying a CAGR of 10%. Thus, HDFC Bank has outperformed the Sensex by over 17 times in the past 21 years. From the unusual billionaires, we talked about Asian Paints, Marico and HDFC Bank. The link of the book is given in the below video description. I request you to read about Astral Poly, which manufactures CPVC pipes, Berger Paints, Axis Bank, and Page Industries, which manufactures Jockey innerwears. From this, my favorite is Astral Poly. With no background in business, Sandeep Engineer wanted to create something of his own. He failed and stood up. As a bonus tip, listen to his inspirational story of Sandeep Engineer by his own words. Link of that video is mentioned below. Subscribe to this channel, like, comment, and share for more informative videos like this. See you in next video.